Now, in our last video, we showed how to make that initial connection. Let's talk now about managing connections to different PI servers. By the way, you don't have to memorize this. All of this is documented fairly well in the Connecting to a System section of the AF User's Guide. So you'll find all the information, all the things that we're talking about today, like, for example, how that the account box is actually used to determine what's the security account that's being used by the AF server to connect to SQL Server. All that's documented in these instructions. Let's now configure a connection to a second AF server. So what I'm talking about here is, back to our little diagram here. Here's what we just did. PI System Explorer was configured to connect to this AF server using the credentials of my user. My user, thankfully, has permission to write to this SQL Server database over here. So now let's add a new player here. I'm going to add a brand new server. This is going to be another AF server. So you can have the same client connect to multiple AF servers. That's not a problem. And by the way, let's ignore for just right now what particular PI servers these two AF servers might be communicating with at this point, or maybe configured to be looking at this point. So let's just ignore the PI data server for right now. So we've got one PI System Explorer. We're going to connect it to two different AF servers, and these are on two physically different boxes. So how would we configure that? Well, what we're going to do is almost exactly what we did before. We're going to go into that dialog box and create now a new PI server. And we're going to specify a new PI server, just like we did before, and provide an account, etc. Except this time it's going to be configured just a little bit differently. So let's take a look at this. I'll go back to this is going to be my SQL Server box. It's my SQL Server box that actually has the PI System Explorer on it. Now right now it's configured properly. It's going to its default PI server. So that's a little different. That's an improvement to what we saw before because we configured it properly. This time I'm going to go into the database option, and this is where you specify the PI system that you're going to connect to. It's basically the AF server you're going to connect to. I only see one listed here. That's the one I just configured. So let me go ahead and add another one. I'm going to add another one by choosing this little ellipsis button right here, and that shows me the list of servers, and it also, through a right mouse click, gives me option to choose a new system. This is going to be a new PI system to connect to. Now I have a second PI system here, and I can either refer to it by IP address or by the actual computer name. This is going to be another system that's running the AF server. This one's actually called, let's write it in properly, it's OSIsoft.trng. That's the name of the computer. And I can go ahead and put that in here as well. But you don't have to. Yeah, those don't have to match. And now in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this account blank. You'll notice that in the balloon help, we actually tell you that it's normally left blank. Normally you would leave that blank. And then what's going to happen is the regular default, it's called the NT network, or excuse me, the network services account. It's a standard resource from Windows. The network services account is going to be used to connect. And in this case, that particular AF server is configured in such a way that that would be sufficient. So the first case we saw was a little different because we had actually specified a username. In this case, we don't need to specify a username. And I suppose I should have shown this one first because that's a lot more common to do it like that. I'll go ahead and attempt to connect. We'll be prompted to save our changes. And there we go. We've been able to establish a connection properly. And the big finish then would be, once you've done that, you can go ahead and select that, and now we can start looking at all the different things on that particular copy of AF. That has, we have several AF databases there, including a training sample. And actually, that was the same one we looked at before. Let's look at this. These are some of our things from some of our learning labs that we do at our live events. Yeah, and now we're looking through, yes, this is a different AF database. So to summarize, what we're doing here is we're establishing connections to the different AF databases that may be out there. As you can see, this particular AF server, I shouldn't say AF database, this particular AF server has three databases associated with it. This AF server has 5, and I can choose from them. So now let's take a look at how this particular one is configured. We said that earlier we would have to take a look at how it's configured on that particular machine, how it's logging on the AF server. So let's go over to this other machine. This is going to be my, yes, this is my separate AF server, the one I just configured a connection to. And we'll take a look at the services applet. And within this services applet, we should see a Pi AF server on here that's configured different than the first AF server we saw. If we look at logon, yeah, this is using just the default. This is that network service account. It's a kind of a utility account that's part of Windows that has no password. And that network service account, it basically grants access to connecting clients by way of their computer name. So that, you know, that's the username that we're associating with this AF server. And now if we look at SQL Server, the SQL Server machine here, this SQL Server machine is actually the same SQL Server. It's the same computer that's running the AF server in this case. This SQL Server machine has an AF servers group, Windows group. And as you can see, the members here, instead of specifying the username as we did before with that, I think it was called my user, in this case they're specifying the computer name. So this is basically granting access to itself. So it has access to write to SQL Server, the SQL Server database for AF on this machine. So to just summarize what we just did with this second connection to this AF server, I'll go back to my SQL Server client, or excuse me, my AF client. The AF client here, it's on this AF client that we defined this particular AF server to have these properties. We're specifying that that's its name, and for the account, we're leaving that blank. In the case of the account being left blank, then what it's going to do is simply try to connect based on its credentials as the computer that it's, you know, the computer that that connection is coming from. Now remember, this account is what we're using to specify, you know, what credentials the AF server uses to write to SQL Server, not the credentials that this AF client uses to connect to the AF server, but it's what it's, as you can see here in the balloon help, the security account that the AF server is running under. So that's the account that has access to write to SQL Server. So in this case, we're leaving that blank. It's just going to use the, you know, kind of the default network approach. And if we look at how that's been implemented here, as you can see, the member of the AF servers here, the members here, is the actual computer name. So the computer name is, you know, that's by the fact that that computer name exists in this AF servers group, it means that this copy of the AF server is going to be able to write to SQL Server. And that can be verified if we go back to the, let's take a look at the services applet. And we look at the Pi AF server. You see it's logging on using that default account. Now here's that topic I wanted to come back to, and that is, you know, we have these two AF servers, but we haven't discussed yet which Pi server these might be actually directing people to. And remember, that's the function of AF. AF is like this wonderful directory, this mechanism for you finding things that you want. And that can be things that would be stored on a Pi server or in other data sources. One copy of AF can point to several different Pi servers, and you can also have two different AF servers that point to the same Pi server. And in fact, that's the situation we have in this case. We've got a Pi server sitting on the network. This particular Pi server is the destination, or I guess the you could say the default data source for things that are being represented in this AF server and also in this AF server. So an AF element can have data references that point to Pi servers, but as you can see, and I'll demonstrate right now, two different AF servers can have elements that point to data sources that are, or data references that are on the same Pi server. Now I can demonstrate this by jumping out to this. This is my SQL Server computer that's running the Pi AF client, if you recall. And I had configured this so that it points to two different servers. Well, this one server, NICGX280, the one we use for most of our class, it has a database called Training Sample. It's something we use commonly for training within OSI. And if you look in the Houston equipment list, there's a tank, tanks 101, 102. Now, these tanks are currently pointing to the attributes of these tanks, the concentration, inside temperature, etc. They are pointing to the following tags. If I hover over them, you'll see that's the current value. And if I look at the references here, see they're referencing this Pi server right there. Each one of those is referencing the same Pi server, or Pi tags on that same Pi server. Well, if we switch over and look at a different database, and let's just make sure that we can tell for sure this is a different database. I'll go ahead and add a new, let's add a new element right here. We'll call this, we'll base this on the tank template. And there we go, it's called chemical tank. I can even check that in to store that. We'll go over all this later on. I just want to demonstrate. So here, now we have this one AF server that is pointing to this Pi server right here. Watch what happens if I switch over to a different AF server. Here's my other AF server. It has the same training sample AF database. It's a sample, as I said, that we move from one AF server to another for training. And I modified the other one. If we take a look at our equipment list here, this still only has the two tanks. But if we take a look at the attributes, if you notice, the values are even the same. These are the exact same values that we saw before because they're pointing to the same Pi server. So I demonstrate this just to reiterate the fact that AF is really just a mechanism to find the things that you're interested in. And it's really agnostic as to, you know, what it actually finds. So you can have two different AF servers pointing to the same Pi server, or one AF server pointing to multiple Pi servers. That's part of the design.